Hello and welcome to Prudent Media News. Now a look at the headlines. People dependent on mining form an organization appeal to the government to continue with legal mining in Goa, demand decrease in buffer zone norms. Viswajit takes battle against Parikar to court, decides to file defamation case against Parikar and Somaya for defaming his name in illegal mining scam, says he doesn't want money, an apology will do. MPT slams government, says Port Trust only renders service, onus lies on the government regarding illegal export. Benawli MLA Mickey Pacheco gets bail, Sessions Court grants bail to Mickey. And Goan football youth development set for a big boost. Australian coaching instructor Norman Boardman gets ready to explain the Aussie techniques. Now the news in detail. All Goa Mining Dependent Organization has appealed to the government to continue with legal mining in Goa. The organization has claimed that around 5 lakh people dependent on mining will be affected and the economy will suffer if legal mining is stopped. The organization wants buffer zone to be 1 kilometer away from the forest. They have planned a huge morcha on 12th October.
People dependent on mining have formed a new organization, All Goa Mining Dependent People's Organization. They have appealed the government to protect legal mining in the state. Around 5 lakh people will get hit if legal mining is stopped. Organization is of the opinion that area marked as buffer zone around forest area should be brought down from 10 kilometers to 1 kilometer. Organization will submit a memorandum to the Chief Minister, Opposition Leader and Speaker on 12th October.
We decided to just come here on 12th and give a representation to Chief Minister, Opposition Leader and Speaker, and this is regarding legal mining, not to stop legal mining, because so many people are depending upon this mining, and people have invested in so many things like trucks, machineries, directly, indirectly they are involved. So this is just to impress upon the government that legal mining should not be stopped. We are totally against illegal mining. Whatever action government have to take, let them take the action.
Goa 60% revenue is dependent on mining. If legal mining is banned, then Goa will lose 900 crores of royalty and 400 crores of octroi. 15,000 truck owners will be unemployed. Govind Sawant says truck owners will have to commit suicide if legal mining is banned.
Mining an ata amka kalon eta ki mining an kide tari 10 kilometer जर बन घातले वाइल्डलाइफ साकून झालेला त्याचा खूप वाईट परिणाम जातलो आणि गोय एक बारीक राज्य असा त्याच्या खाती मी कमीत कमी त्याका साधारणपणे 1 किलोमीटर करीत झालेला वडले लोक माझ्या दृष्टी साकून बरे जातले आणि अशा वेळार जर अशात जर चालू उरात जसे वयर महाराष्ट्रात आत्महत्या शेतकरी करता त्या पद्धतीन आमचे लोक आत्महत्या करच्याशिवाय त्यांना मार्ग ना.
अ रिपोर्टर फ्रॉम पणजी बासुरी देसाई विथ व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट सर्वेश विळुस्कर.
Health Minister Viswajit Rane has decided to file a defamation case against Manohar Parikar and senior BJP leader Kiret Somaiya. Parikar and Somaiya had alleged that Junior Rane is involved in illegal mining. Viswajit says he does not want any compensation but wants an apology from both the BJP leaders. Viswajit says his father Pratap Singh Rane has asked him to clear his name from the ongoing controversy.
Tussle between Junior Rane and Parikar has now become more complex. Viswajit feels Parikar does not know how to politically tackle him. Viswajit says he has no role in mining, but he supports legal mining as it supports livelihood of many people in Bicholi and Sattari. Now Rane says enough is enough. Parikar and Somaiya have crossed the limit and his lawyer is filing defamation case against the duo.
So under Sushant Nadkarni's stamp, this notice will be served on both these people in the state of Goa. I will circulate the copies because I had to do it because speaker also advised me that not as a speaker but as a, because I am his son, that name is coming, and I last 20-40 years I'm in Goa politics, my name is not in any controversy, so kindly clear yourself. I don't want any compensation, I just want apology that you're wrong. Did you see Manohar Parrikar on NDTV? What did he say? He only makes allegations against the Chief Minister and me and other colleagues. But when he was on national TV, he drew a blank. He couldn't open his mouth. He tell him not to just make noise here in the state. After the assembly, he shouts.
Meanwhile, Vishwajit has decided to consider views of private hospital owners over state-funded Arogya Bima Yojana. Many private hospital owners have expressed grievances that reimbursement offered by the government is too less and it is not affordable.
We are going to see that we convince the private players. They had some issues. We will try our best to resolve it. Those rate conflicts have to be resolved. And how to resolve it, we have taken the association itself on board to guide us. So within what we have tendered and what we and they can do together.
A senior reporter from Panji, Rakesh Kanolkar, with video journalist Sarvesh Veluskar.
Murmala Port Trust has slammed Goa government on the issue of illegal export of iron ore. Goa government had blamed MPT for not monitoring the illegal export. MPT says mined iron ore passes through different rungs of administrative control mechanism before it enters its jurisdiction. Therefore, state government departments are the competent authority to ensure the legality of iron ore that enters the port area. Port Trust only renders service.
MLAs from both ruling and opposition had blamed the MPT over illegal ore exports. During the assembly session, Chief Minister Kamath had pointed finger towards MPT for not controlling any illegal export of iron ore. Now MPT has slammed Goa government. MPT feels a campaign is on to tarnish its image. Note issued by the MPT says, the whole area of mines is under the administrative control of the state government. Can the legality of iron ore not be verified by state machinery when it is transported for such a long period through different modes of transport? MPT is of the opinion that iron ore gets transported through trucks, then loaded at jetties, and then carried by barges. It feels the state government should monitor any illegal flow of ore. It says Custom RTO, Director of Mines and Geology, Indian Bureau of Mines and other agencies has a mandate to act against smuggling of minerals. It is the responsibility of the departments of mine to monitor the same and issue certificates as regards to the legality of ore. In case an illegality is detected by the state mines department, it is their responsibility to inform the regulatory bodies like customs so that the cargo consignment is not cleared by the customs for export. Since February, MPT has been asking iron ore exporters to produce NOC from the Department of Mines and Geology. But MPT says this NOC is not very discreet about the legality of source of the iron ore. Bureau report, Prudent Media.
South Goa Sessions Court has granted conditional bail to Benali MLA Mickey Pacheco. Mickey is released on a bond of Rs 15,000 and a witness. He was arrested in the junior engineer assault case. Mickey's bail plea was earlier rejected by the additional sessions court.
Banavli MLA Mickey Pacheco is granted an anticipatory bail on Monday by South Goa Sessions Court. South Goa Sessions Court Judge Bimba Thadi pronounced the verdict. Mickey's counsel, Advocate Amit Palekar, gave us more detail.
The revision has been held to be admissible against the order of the assistant session judge. So that revision has been admitted. We have filed for bail. Bail has been granted. He has been released on bail with one surety of 15,000 and the matter has been posted for final arguments on 10th of November. 10th of November for final arguments.
What time? Evening?
Afternoon.
Mickey Pacheco was arrested in junior engineer assault case on 5th October after he was convicted. Sessions Court Judge Irshad Aga had dismissed his appeal against JMFC order, sentencing him and his bail plea on last Wednesday. The court reduced the sentence to 6 months from 1 year. Mickey was arrested and taken to Sada jail. Later, he was admitted in the GMC. Our reporter from Madgaon, Ramesh Naik Raut.
It's time now for a short break. Stay tuned.